Hey guys, so recently a member of the NES Tetris community by the username of Goel made a version of Tetris with triangles. And immediately as I took a peek at it, I thought it would be really cool to just stop, sit back, and record my raw reaction to it because it looked like a really fascinating project. So I reached out to him and asked if it was all right if I made a video on it, and he said, yeah, absolutely. And it turns out the video he made to explain the game, he was actually trying to do it kind of in my style, which is really cool. So I'm gonna give it a watch for the first time right now.
Tetris with triangles.
Oh my goodness. They got a piece going through one of the other pieces over there.
I still wasn't sure what the pieces would look like, so I made some rough sketches to figure it out.
Oh my gosh, she really went all out. I can see all sorts of notes in there for the delayed auto shift. Okay, so something that's really interesting is that he's gone with isosceles triangles. He's basically splitting a square in half. When I had thought about, you know, like what if Tetris had existed with triangles in the past, I'd always thought of like equilateral triangles, something that kind of looks like this. But the problem with that is that there's really only one option for the piece unless you want your pieces to be really disjointed. So you kind of have to make a compromise.
I wrote a program that would generate every possible piece consisting of some amount of triangles.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome. This is the kind of stuff I wish I could do because I'm not a programmer. I'm just a video editor.
The triangles must be connected by an edge and not just a vertex.
Yeah, this is an awkward shape, and this is kind of what Tetris Effects had to do with some of its triminos. For brief spurts of time in the mystery mode, you'll get pieces that are just three, so they kind of have to have some disjointed pieces. It's weird. It probably wouldn't work as a full mode, which is why it's only like an additional challenge in the middle.
These are some of the pieces it generated.
Oh, I didn't think about the fact that if you have four triangles, you're gonna have way more piece options than if it's squares. Okay, so he was trying 3, 4, 5 triangle combinations, I guess trying to figure out what's the optimal way to do this.
To create the game, I started with a 10x20 grid where each cell was able to hold 2 right triangles.
Oh my gosh, some of these pieces look really, really uncomfortable. This is reminding me a little bit right off the bat of Pentris, which has a lot of like really cursed pieces in it because they have all these like inward shapes where you have to insert other stuff into them, and they're just like, if you get a bad piece sequence, it's like impossible to put anything together. And really the most playable versions of Pentris are the ones that give you every possible mino going all the way down to 1, so you have those little tiny minos that you can use to fill in the gaps sometimes.
A fundamental mechanic of every Tetris game is rotation. I changed the colors and then copied and pasted the code to add clockwise rotation.
Oh, what the heck? That looks like a big old glitch.
Forgot to change that. Trying to fill a line was nearly impossible.
Oh gosh, yeah. Those are so uncomfortable.
I then tried reducing the amount of triangles in each piece from 4 to 3.
Okay.
This made it much easier, but it was still too difficult.
Wow, even with only 3. I would have thought if your combos were 3 that you'd have only a couple pieces and it would be quite easy.
I asked some experienced Tetris players for some suggestions on how to make line clearing easier.
Oh, I recognize some of these people.
They also helped me realize another problem. Some holes could actually be impossible to fill.
That's fascinating. Because it takes 2 triangles to fill that in, it's impossible. Oh my gosh.
To solve this, I added another piece, a single triangle. It could be used to fill in any holes and keep your stack clean.
Yeah, this is kind of what Pentris had to do.
I decided to change the movement algorithm to allow for more tricks.
Okay.
Now, pieces can move in multiple directions at the same time.
This is really interesting. This is the sort of thing you have to go through when thinking a game through from the ground up. All these extra things, they don't immediately strike me as sacrilegious because it kind of goes back to the original spirit of Tetris. Like, a T-spin, technically, if you're trying to have, like, physical wooden blocks fall in real life on a board, you're not able to do a T-spin. And I think spins are a great addition to NES Tetris. Like, if you didn't have spins, the game would be harder.
To make the game even easier and stick with the triangle theme, I made single triangles always come out 3 at a time. I also changed it so that lines wait to be cleared until all 3 single triangles have been placed. This means that instead of only being able to score singles and doubles, you can create a setup like this and score a Tritris.
Ah.
A Tritris gives far more points than a double, so the strategy is to get as many as possible.
That's very clever. I like it. I didn't even think about the fact that trying to compare like the equivalent of like a single, double, triple, or Tetris would be a nightmare. I want to try and see if I can figure out the strategy for myself, so I'm not going to watch this yet. I'm going to try playing it on my own. Oh boy. All right. This is one of those things where I think it's going to take me a while to just get used to how all the pieces fit together. Is that able to fit in there? No, it's the wrong orientation. All right, I'm going to try and set up a crazy tuck. Can I get that all the way underneath? Okay, I can. All right, so how am I going to spin this in there? Oh, I did it! Haha! Dang it, I wasn't able to do it. Okay. Finally got something to cleanly go over there. Dang it! I'm still getting used to how they rotate here. I have a feeling this first game isn't gonna be that great. Okay, so I should be able to get my first line here, maybe. Couldn't figure out how to do it. I'm just kind of spamming rotation. Okay, got it. Okay. All right, here's my first line. No? Oh, because it waits until all of them are done. Yay! 195 points. Wait, am I getting pushdown points? I am. All right, I should be pushing down. I think I'm about to get a line without, finally, without the triangles. With the single triangles, at least. There we go. Dang it. This is like me watching my friends play Tetris for the very first time. Oh, that's interesting. The triangles can just fall through. I didn't realize that. It's so weird. This stack is so terrible, I'm tempted to just kind of start over now that I have a little bit more of an idea of what I'm doing. All right, let's just top out. Score 470. Okay. I think this is my least favorite piece already. I don't like this piece whenever it comes up. I am never quite sure what to do with it. Okay, so this bloody piece better be able to fit into itself somehow. I don't even think it does. This piece is cursed. Darn, this was going so well to start. Okay, so can pieces just fall through if it's like that? Let me see. Okay, they can. Okay, now I think I understand this mechanic a bit more. Okay, so I gotta set up these thingies. Okay, I'm gonna try and set up for a Tritris. Okay, I need to start filling this in. Okay, next triangle set, I'll be able to get the Tritris. Okay, if I set this up like this, it should just fall through, right? It does, okay. Oh my gosh, and I get two cursed green pieces. All right, we have our Tritris. Boom. Number three, let's go. So I just gotta start digging this out. I never know what to do with the green piece. Can I tuck this in here? No, I am so bad at this. I think this game is pretty much dead. I got one Tritris. I think I'm dead. So one thing that's very different from normal Tetris that I'm having to now think about is there's a strategic element to setting up holes that are accessible. So if I have an opening where I can put the little single unit triangles and they can fall all the way down, then a hole isn't a problem. But if the hole on top is in a different orientation, then I have to do some rotation magic that I'm not quite sure how to do yet. So I think I'm ready to see some more strategies. Okay, strategies, how not to suck. Please enlighten me.
The first tip is no sharp edges. Mm-hmm. The second tip is to create a V shape that can fit almost every piece.
Interesting.
The final tip is how to score a Tritris. Knowing how to set up for a Tritris is vital as it scores the most points. Gradually build your well along with the rest of your stack and try not to create a weird spike. I also recommend using bottom triangles for your well so that if you need to burn and don't have any single triangles, other pieces can clear lines.
So this is really cool. Basically, getting those three little triangles in a row is the equivalent of a long bar. But then also, it's kind of a middle ground between the Pentris version where it just kind of gives you everything, and then Cursed Pentris where it only gives you the Pentris pieces. This, I really like it. I think after a bunch of beta testing here, he's really struck on a great balancing act of game mechanics, and I want to try it out a little bit more now. Oh my gosh. His high score took 35 minutes. Oh dear. All right, armed with all this knowledge, let's go. Okay, so I wanna set up the Vs, right? So that's the kind of formation I want, stuff like that. Okay. Oh, but then I get one of these annoying pieces, but I can set up for this, can't I? Did I mess it up? No, I didn't. Whoa, yes, okay. I don't like the direction this is going, but it could still be, oh, please tell me that goes in. Yes, okay, there we go. We got half our Tritris built. I'm gonna bank on something I can shove in there. Okay, the Tritris is set up now. Okay, this is perfect. I can fix this whole board now. We'll just slip that in. Perfect, yes, okay. Okay, here we go. About to get another Tritris. Board's looking immaculate. Yes, victory. Haha! Didn't have to sell out my stack one bit. Oh my gosh, and I can already set up for the next one. Let's go. Ooh, and I'm getting the cursed piece next. What setup works here? You need those valleys, those little dips. That's what cleanly solves it. I just gotta hope that I get the white triangles real soon. I'm getting white triangle droughted. Man, I blew it. Okay, let's start digging down finally. Oh no, they don't clear until it's over. Gosh darn it. That means it can't go through, right? Oh man, that's all right. Okay, what's the orientation that works for this? It's that, right? Yes, okay. Finally figuring out how to use those cursed green pieces. What's the best I can do here? Can get one single there. That green piece can fit, I'll call them C's. All right, the C can fit all the way on the left. Okay, so that works. Oh my gosh, my first double. I think that's my first double. As soon as I figured out that way the C could fit, those pieces became so much less intimidating. Haha. That hurts. Oh, I'm dumb. That was two rows below, not one. Oh, dang it, 2607. Let's try another game. 2866. Oh my gosh, 10 lines. This game is so tough. I gotta say, this is probably a game that somebody could get really good at. Let me watch his world record game. Let's just play it at 2x speed. Very, very clever. There's the double. It looks so easy when he's doing it. Oh my gosh. Like, he's just got to figure it out. This is giving me flashbacks of when I was brand new into the Tetris scene and, you know, everybody just kind of knew how to put the pieces in places where it didn't make sense to me, but it made sense to them and it just all worked out, just like magic. I'm just blown away. And that still was only 92 lines from the world record holder. I would love to see this develop into a scene. I wanna play this more on stream. Thank you so much to Goel for creating this game. This was so much fun. Be sure to go to his page, check out the video. I'll have it linked in the description. And also go play his game, see if you can beat his score. Because I love seeing new variations, new takes on Tetris like this. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.